If that fills you with nightmares about range anxiety and charging points, then stick around and let's see if the Zoe's good points outweigh its limitations. To begin with, let's consider how practical the Zoe is, noting first of all it comes with 5 doors as standard, unlike a lot of small cars. And the battery is packed under the seats, resulting in quite a large boot for such a small car. Perfect for this large suitcase, or perhaps a baby buggy. However, this backrest, while folding down, creates more space, it doesn't fold flat, and it doesn't split 60-40. In the back, there's room for 2 adults, although legroom will be a squeeze for taller passengers. Up here in the front, there are plenty of places to store your everyday clutter, including cup holders, storage here, a little shelf here, and decent-sized door bins. The dash is neat and futuristic, complete with this touchscreen showing essential vehicle information, such as battery life. Talking of which, let's go for a drive. But not before I give you a score for practicality, for which the Zoe scores 8 out of 10. There are 2 things that immediately hit you when you first drive the Zoe. One is how high up you sit, and that's thanks to the batteries being underneath the seat. And the second is how quiet it is. Now, considering the Zoe will mainly be driven in towns and cities, both are real bonuses, because you get a fantastic view of the road, and the peace and quiet gives a real sensation of relaxation. Performance is good from a standing start, because that electric motor gives it all from 0 revs. However, one criticism I do have is take it onto the open road and it soon runs out of puff. You can really feel that electric motor only pushes out 87 brake horsepower. As for 0 to 60 times, 13 and a half seconds. Hardly stuff dreams are made of. Well, not my dreams anyway. The regenerative braking also takes some getting used to, the system harvesting power to feed back into the battery to maximise range, which can make the car feel quite jerky when you slow down. Ah yes, range. Renault says it would do 130 miles on a full charge. From our experience, it's more like 80. At least you'll be having fun though, because the Zoe handles really well. That's thanks to partly because the weight of the batteries is so low down, and when you turn into corners, there's a really good response. True, the ride can be a bit fidgety when you're going quickly, but all in all, the Zoe offers a refreshingly different